गुड डे, नमस्ते एंड ग्रीटिंग्स फ्रॉम इंडिया टू ऑल ऑफ यू. आई एम डॉक्टर संगीता ढमडेरे, लाइब्रेरियन, डायरेक्टर नॉलेज रिसोर्स सेंटर, मॉडर्न कॉलेज ऑफ आर्ट्स कॉमर्स साइंस, पुणे फ्रॉम इंडिया. टुडे इन दिस उगन स्टेट चैप्टर ऑफ नाइजेरियन लाइब्रेरी एसोसिएशन, आई एम गोइंग टू स्पीक ऑन चेंज मैनेजमेंट एंड रिलेवेंस ऑफ लाइब्रेरीज इन रिमोट सर्कमस्टेंसेस एक्सपीरियंस फ्रॉम इंडिया. As all of we know, since last one and a half year, whole world has shaken due to this COVID-19 virus, and it has affected all areas, economy, and many people are dying due to this. Many health issues are coming, and even due to lockdown, many business and many school colleges are closed, and virtual media is been used by all of us. Even software people are working from home, so change is inevitable, and we all of us need to adapt to the change. So here I am going to give you information about our library of Modern College of Arts Commerce Science. Our knowledge resource center has established in 1992, and it is fully automated and well equipped with quality print and online resources. We provide open access to all our readers, and our library is user friendly and techno driven. The main purpose of our library is to freely disseminate knowledge and support teaching, research, and other academic activities of college. This knowledge research center is operating on need-based approach rather than usual rule-based treatment given in all other institutes and libraries. And our objective is to enrich collection, optimum utilization of existing resources, adding readership number every year, enhancing reading habit in students and staff, promoting library as a vibrant learning unit, and promote use of ICT and open source softwares. And also we spread awareness about electronic resources among the readers. The main motto of all library staff is to give them information maximum number of times, maximum number of ways in minimum time. These are various sections in our knowledge research center. We have spacious reading hall, we have stacks, we have UGC Network Resource Center. UGC has funded for our Knowledge Resource Center to develop digital library and give access to internet to all readers. Periodical displays there. We provide photocopying facility to our students. Ready reference section is there, where we have kept all multi volumes, encyclopedia, dictionaries, handbooks, etc., and bound volumes of periodicals, so that student can read those collection in that room only, and they cannot borrow it to the home. The computer attendance is there, computerized attendance is there. Whenever students or readers come in the library, they can scan their ID and their attendance is enrolled. In India, COVID-19 situation is on 18th March onwards, the government declared lockdown, and on 20th March, from 18th March onwards, all colleges were closed, and on 20th March, there was nationwide one day lockdown, and 21st March onwards, 21st March 2020 onwards, for 1 month there was lockdown, and it continued till May. So during this lockdown, in April, the college started conducting online meetings, and they were starting to discuss with the teachers, faculty members, that what can we do sitting at home, can we take online lectures, how to conduct on exams of the students, because almost all portion has been taught, and only students were waiting to give examinations. So for PG students in May, 2020 online classes has been started, and their syllabus, they completed their syllabus using online platforms like Google Classroom and Zoom meetings. In June, first and second year students were promoted, and they are exempted from the exams, annual exams, and they are promoted to the second and third year. But for third year students and PG students, the exam was compulsory. So in June, 8th June onwards, our college has started, and online teachers were delivering lectures online to the students. Students were not allowed to come in the colleges, because still lockdown was there, and many areas in Pune city or all over India were affecting due to coronavirus. So lockdown was there, but partially teachers were coming for few hours, and they were taking lectures online. In September onwards, college teachers also coming to the colleges full time, and they were conducting lectures in the colleges, and other activities were going on, but students were not allowed in the college. In February 2021, the corona situation were little bit better in Pune city, so college has started, and even government has given permission to teach students offline. Only 50% students were allowed to come in the college, but within one and a half week, again corona situation got worst, and then again college got shut down and online classes were started. So till now the situation is same, and since last 1 month in Pune city, the situation is very worst, and corona patients are increasing in thousands in one city. So change is inevitable, and we need to face, or we need to accept the change, and we need to change ourselves with the time. So even coronavirus is also changes, and different strains are coming, different mutations are there of coronavirus. So here I would like to give you one example of wild beast. As you know, wild beast is the animal who runs in the forest, and lions and other leopards are always ready to catch them and eat them. So they runs, and their babies, they deliver babies also while running, and their babies within 1 minute they get up and they runs. So how they accepted the change and how they muted themselves is the best example of the change management.
Many are inevitably picked off by predators. The vast majority survive. Each female will give birth to one calf each year. After an 8 to 8 years, they can stand and then run within minutes before. Each female will give birth to one calf each year after an 8 to 8.5 month gestation. The calves are very unsteady on their feet to begin with. They can stand and then run within minutes of being born.
So, even educational institute and all other fields are accepting the change. And in our library now, rather than accessing physical collection and sitting in the reading hall and reading the books, now students are getting all books and reading material on their fingertips, on their mobile, laptop and PCs. During lockdown, libraries were closed, completely closed, and online communication with teachers were there, and libraries are providing remote access to the subscribe e-resources and other free resources. Myself provided the e-resources to the students during lockdown. using Padlet platform. On Padlet, I have given links to all free resources. And for online resources, we have login password based system. Even we have institutional repository. Using this space software, we have created institutional repository. We have taken membership of Enlist Consortia. And all these resources we made available to the students. During lockdown and corona situation, many universities, publishers and national institutes became generous and they have made their collection available to all. So we have provided information about those universities, publishers and national institutes catalog and links to our readers. And even we have given access to educational videos and virtual labs to our students. When after lockdown, when college opened in the month of June, first we need to do the pest control and termite treatment to the library, because library was closed for 2-3-4 months, and therefore the disinfecting, sanitizing all surfaces of library, the dusting the blue books, cleaning the racks, and all library cleaning work we have started. And as per the COVID-19 guidelines of WHO, UNESCO, and many big national libraries, we have started using masks, we were using sanitizers, face shield, counter shield, and we have given gloves to our staff, those who are issuing books. We were continuously disinfecting the surfaces, all tables and furniture we were disinfecting, and the written books we were isolating in the different box. As the quarantine policy is there for people who are affecting corona, we were applying this quarantine policy to the all written material, and we are keeping aside for 2-3 days and then we are keeping them at their place. Social distancing was mandatory and we were following that. And in day-to-day functions, the issuing of books or physical reading material were limited to the readers. We were issuing books to only teachers, and for students, they were able to return the books which they have issued before lockdown or before corona situation, and we were not taking any fines from the students. Normally, usually we were taking fines if they returns books late. So we excused fine to our students, and we were providing electronic resources access to the students. So during and post lockdown, in India, different colleges were providing access to e-resources, and we were conducting library and information literacy programs and library orientation online to newly admitted students using Zoom or Google Classroom platforms. We were using Flip Classroom. We were making videos and circulating to the students. We were giving e-document delivery services. We were using social media to educate our patrons, and we were conducting online exhibitions also. In India, there is one Google group, and it is very huge group. Thousands of librarians are there from all over India, and the librarians were requesting to the colleagues to provide the research papers or articles or books. See here, I have attached the screenshot of the request, and accordingly the librarians were providing the online e-material to the students using interlibrary loan facility or asking the colleagues for specific papers. Here, as I told you, we were using Team, Zoom, Google Classroom, Messenger, WhatsApp messages to train the teachers. I have used Padlet platform for creating portal for online resources, And even I have organized virtual book exhibitions. I have communicated with book vendors and publishers to contribute to the contribute their collection to this platform, and we exhibited the virtual book exhibition, and different sources we have given on Padlet to our students. In e-journals, we provided Doge Open Access Journals database, Core database, PLOS database, scienceopen.com, and even we asked our teachers to use Unpaywall and download that plugin. Even we provided different base database, scientific research database, ERIC database, PMC database, SSRN database, freefulltext.com, PaperCity, Microsoft Academic resources of e-journals, and many other e-journals we have given access to our teachers and students. And for e-books, we have provided different databases and websites like OpenStax, BookBoon, BookRix, FreeBooks.net, Open Textbook Library, Page by Page Books, ManyBooks, MyPustak.com, Internet Archive, ReadPrint, and BC Campus OpenED, along with Project Gutenberg. Here, the students were able to access reference books, but for textbook, we have not given any source, because here in local publishers, they were, the textbooks were very cheap, and in our library, we don't recommend students to go through the textbooks, and we emphasize giving access to reference books only. And along with e-journals and e-books, we have given access to EPG Paathshala, where all PG students can listen to the lectures and videos of eminent subject experts from all over India. And Swayam platform is there, where online courses are there, virtual labs is there, National Digital Library of India is there. Swayam Prabha is free DTS channel for education, where they can listen to the lectures of different experts. And there is CEC channel also, and we have given access to these to the students to study at home, and we kept them engaged in the education field, because due to lockdown, many students were busy in mobile, playing games, watching movies, but we were keeping busy, our teachers were keeping busy with the, giving them different links of from these resources, and we were insisting them to study. Even we have institutional repository using DSpace, that access also we have given to our students. I used Google custom search for the giving single search access to the different databases. The Google custom search is a programmable search engine. We can call it as a federated search engine. Up to 10 different databases we can add in this, and the result it shows from the all 10. See, here I have created one search engine. It is Modern College of Arts, Commerce, Science free e-journals. And I'll show you how to add a new search engine. Here you can give the name or title for the site to search. You can select language. Here we can say Modern College eBooks. Create here manybooks.com. Create Google Custom Search is a platform where you can add up to 10 databases, and the result it shows from all 10 databases. You can add one or two databases also, but the limit is 10 databases. So for this is a very good platform. Those who don't have digital library platform or federated search engine, they can use Google Custom Search Engine. So here I have created Google Custom Search Engine for our library. Now I'll show you how to create the new search engine. Here you can add jget.com or jstor.com. Here you can add create. Here you will get the public UR for the web, and you can manage the search engine control panel. Here you can add description to this side, you can add keyword, and this is the URL. Here you can add new database. Save. See, here it has been added. We can add jstor.org. Save. Add jget.org. manybooks.com. See, here I have added four different databases. If we want to search from this database, you can go to the public URL of this website, and here you can search any term, microbes, and you will get the readings. See, JSTOR, from JSTOR you are getting this. Even from Google Scholar you will get records. Using this Google Custom Search, you can provide access to different databases, free or paid databases. And during lockdown, means we all teachers and college staffs were updating our knowledge also. We were updating ourselves regarding COVID-19 and what precaution we need to take. What are different policies for educational institutes? What are different guidelines for libraries? And we were attending webinars and online courses. We were participating in various quizzes. And once the college will start within 1 or 2 months, we are planning to implement offline library services also, as we are proposing additional budget for the sanitizer, oximeter, UV light cabinets, and for more ebooks. And we are asking them different budget for ebooks and e-journals. We want to we want to increase our electronic resources, paid resources in e-form. And once the library will start, the reading hall capacity will be 50%. Due to social distancing, we cannot give reading facility to all students. Then for issue returns, we will prefer close access for few months until this coronavirus will go fully, because books are also get contaminated with the touch, and the virus may spread due to touch. So close access will be there. Our library staff will give the books to the students at the counter, whichever book they need, because we have OPAC at the entrance of the library. They can search the book, they can tell accession number, class number, and it will be easy to locate the book or reading material to our staff, and they can issue it easily. And issue return timings also, we are giving in shifts, because for different means, for arts faculty, for science faculty, for commerce faculty, we will keep different timings so that no rush will be there in the library. So thank you very much. I just wanted to convey what is the situation in the India. In India, many national institutes, IITs, research institutes, they have huge collection of electronic resources, and they are subscribing and they are investing crores of rupees to subscribe different databases. Even Web of Science, Scopus databases they are subscribing. But at college level, for UG and PG students, the resources are limited, and every college cannot spend money to subscribe all the databases. But we take institutional memberships, we give access to our university resources to our teachers. So with this, we are providing sufficient resources to our teachers and students, and we are trying to cope up with this situation. I hope we all come out of this COVID situation as soon as possible, because it gets means we feel that now coronavirus is gone, and now situation will get better, and again it comes with force and it is spreading widely. So I wish all other countries also that coronavirus should go fast, and means should we come out of this COVID-19 situation and live better life. And again, colleges and universities, academic institutions, and all other fields starts normally. So thank you for giving me opportunity to speak